Hello, welcome to Woman's Angle. Today, we'll be talking about a person called Woman. Woman was just a period in a female's life after she has passed through childhood and adolescence, generally around age 18. The word woman can be used generally to mean any adult female human as contrasted with girl. There are various words that are used to describe the quality of being a woman. The term femininity is used to refer to a set of typical female qualities associated with a certain attitude to gender roles. Another word is womanliness, distinctively feminine nature. These are just a few among other themes. On today's edition, we have with us Ms. Arit Efanga. She's a broadcaster with years of experience, and she claims she enjoys her work and she's passionate about it.
Of course, I'm very passionate about my job and I love my job.
You're welcome.
Thank you for having me here.
I know this may sound like a funny question or an unusual question, but let's begin with it. How has it been being a woman?
Being a woman has been quite interesting, but very challenging.
I recall
this morning I was talking to a colleague of mine and I told her, if there is anything like reincarnation, I'd love to come back as a woman. I love the thrills.
But some people claim they want to come back and be a man because it's a man who's old.
No. It's my world.
Whether you're a man or a woman.
Yes. So I want to come back. If there's anything like reincarnation, I'd want to come back as a woman.
So how's it been?
Very, very, very challenging. But at the same time, very interesting.
For me, it's been fun. A learning experience. Knowing that everybody's unique in his own way. I'm unique, you're unique. Let's use our uniqueness to make the world a better place.
Very true.
And because of this, we have different things we live by. There are various values we ought to live by. For you, what are those values? And indeed, what do you think is the value or are the values that women ought to live by?
Well, we're talking about values that women ought to live by. I believe that every woman has different values because we have different backgrounds.
Yes.
Now we find ourselves among different people every day. And so I have different values for different aspects of my life.
Okay.
For instance, for my work, I have the value of diligence. It's very important to me. For my family, I have the value of love and commitment to my family. Then we come to relationships. I owe my friends loyalty.
Yes.
You know, my relationships. And then to God. God is above every other thing. So by the time I merge all of these values together, I find myself living a life that is kind of pre-ordered.
Okay.
It helps me stay on course.
Oh, I've never really looked at it the way you look at it, like my work, these are the values, my family, these are the values, God, these are the values. I just look at it generally, honesty, humility, diligence. Honesty, if you're honest, it's sweet.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody doubts you. And if someone hears that, oh, this person was caught doing it, like, that person, are you sure? But when you are dishonest, nobody takes what you say at face value. It means that this person has doctored it to make it look sweet for me to believe.
Mm.
Then when you are humble, you can't stand with anybody. Kings, presidents, just because you are humble. It doesn't mean you're stupid. It just means this person is down to earth.
Exactly.
Then diligence. Why being a mediocre? Why not do what you have to do and do it well?
Mm-hmm.
You know, these values that you mentioned now, how has it been? Has it been challenging? Has it been easy to live by these values?
Well, there is nothing easy. You know, there's nothing easy about doing something good.
Okay.
If you're determined to do something good, you would always come across challenges. So, of course, it's not been easy. It's been very challenging.
Yeah.
But, you know, we all work, we strive towards perfection. And so I find myself every day getting better at sticking to these values.
Mm. Okay, being a patriarchal society that Nigeria is, what are those challenges, especially at work? Because I know that majority of women, most women, where they face the most challenges are at work. What are those challenges?
Well, you know, I work with the media.
Yes.
And the media kind of allows a blend, a proper blend of the male and female folk.
Okay.
Because it's the media who gets to talk about gender equality and
yes,
all of that.
Yes, yes.
You know, so within this setting, if you're somebody who handles the camera, you have cameramen, you have camera women.
Okay.
Once you know that, okay, your tough is camera work, you stick to it. You get to doing your job. If yours is presentation, You stick to your job, you get doing your job. So within the media, I've not really seen that that division of, okay, this one has to do this because he's a man, or this one has to do this because he's a woman, or she's a woman. But more often than not, it usually seems like the media world favors women.
Because
for some reason, the owners of this, especially the televisions, you know, and television stations, they prefer to project women. You have more women,
at
the forefront. And it could also be because the men prefer, you know, to do things
tough
they think,
jobs.
Yes, more serious. You find them in engineering and all of that. But generally, within the media circle where I have worked, and then another thing could also be the organizations I've worked with.
Okay.
There's always been that balance. I've never had the challenge of being sidelined because I'm a woman. Okay. I've never had that challenge.
Now, as a woman who has seen two generations of women, your mother and that of yours, what's the relationship or difference between the modern woman and the woman you knew while growing up?
Wow. You know, that's one thing that's been on my mind for a long time now. You know, my generation, I find mothers who are not as committed to their children as the generation of my mother was.
Okay.
Because my mom was a woman, she was a banker. She had a banking career. But she would come back from work and make sure we had food to eat. We didn't have a house help.
Okay.
You know, she did the cooking. She would take care of us. She made sure everything was moving on fine. And she was a career woman. But now, that's one generation. My generation, I find mothers who have 3-4 housemaids.
Yes, different duties.
Yes, different duties. And the house still seems to be in chaos. So motherhood, I think it's one major difference. The difference between the generation of my mother and my generation is too wide. Too wide for comfort.
And what do you think you can do to balance that? Or at least, from what you say, you admire your mother's time.
Mm.
And from this time, it looks like, why pack so many ourselves when they can't even be better than what we had back then? What do you think we ought to do right?
What I think we should do right is the younger generation, that's my generation, needs more of mentorship.
Okay.
I think we've derailed too much away from our mothers.
Mm.
And we think, okay, our mothers, old school. You know,
this is the new
generation. And interestingly, we already have another generation, which I call the Facebook generation. You know, so I think we need to go back to our mothers. We need to go back to them and learn from them.
Okay.
You know, how were they doing these things? And I would always say my mom, when we're growing up, if my mom is cooking, you dare not go and stay in the room. What are you doing in the room?
As a girl, including the boys.
My brothers are fabulous cooks.
Oh boy.
You know, what are you doing in the room? Do you understand? So she made sure you were around to learn.
Yeah.
And so if there are things that we think we have lapses here and there, it means there are certain lessons we did not learn, or we were not opportuned to learn, or we refused to learn.
Yeah, that is it. I think that is more like it.
Yes, we need to get back to that point of mentorship. May not necessarily be with our biological mothers, but you know, women we respect.
Yes.
You know, we need to go back to that. You know, learning from them how to take care of our homes, how to balance our career lives, you know, and family life, and more importantly, how to make our husbands happy. Because I think that's one thing our mothers got really right. That
because the rate of divorce in those days and now, this our generation, it's like we can't even tolerate our husbands. Any small thing, you hear the woman rebelling already.
I think on the flip side, maybe the men are getting overly ambitious that they can't tolerate their wives. Because
okay,
I grew up hearing, you know, men say things like, please leave that woman alone, women talk too much.
Okay.
But now, what you're hearing more is, if she talks too much, I'm like, just slap her off. So it's both ways.
Yeah.
Maybe the women are getting too much of a talkative, or the men are getting too impatient.
Okay.
So there has to be that balance there.
Okay. There are days when we sit and reality stares in the eyeballs. When do you think it dawns on a woman, or on a girl, or on a lady, I mean, that she's no longer a girl?
Different strokes for different folks.
Okay, for you.
Yes, because, you know, for a woman, a girl who grew up in a home where she had to fend for herself from teenagehood, The day she realizes that she's a woman is completely different from a girl who grew up in a home where everything was given to her.
Yeah.
You understand? And also, speaking from my own perspective, I would say the day it dawned on me that I'm no longer a girl, that I'm now a woman, was when I found myself in the university, you know, and then I got back home. I was all alone in the house, and there was nobody at home who would have prepared food for me or who would have cleaned up something for me. And I realized that, babe, you're so on your own right now.
Exactly.
There's no mommy's food to run back to.
Exactly.
So where am I now? You balance your work and school and food life.
It's your life.
It's totally your own business.
Yes, exactly.
No, so at that point when I realized that, you know, I was left on my own in the university, I had to take my decisions by myself. You know, I had to decide on when I left my house, when I got back home. I realized that, man, grow up.
Yeah.
That was it.
This is the time you've been waiting for all your life.
Honestly,
you are a woman now.
We've always been looking forward to being a woman. Finally, it has come.
What do you think is a woman's greatest fear?
A woman's greatest fear. You know, all of those things, it's different for people. You know, I won't say generally. One would say a woman's greatest fear, you might say, is finding out that somebody she loves is in love with some other person. But, you know, for me, my greatest fear, you know, as a woman, is realizing that I've fallen below standards.
Okay.
You know, there are goals that I have set for myself, and whether we like it or not, there are certain expectations that society, you know, looks forward from us. Realizing that I've fallen below standard without realizing that I have fallen below standard is a huge problem for me. It's one of my greatest fears.
I think mine is the fear of not being accepted, like for who you are. Not, you know, we live in a world where a lot of people want you to be what they want you to be. Now, not they don't care. Even when we were growing up, some parents be like, we believe that you, this girl, you have to be a nurse. Mm-hmm. You have to be this. Now, but maybe in deep down, you want to be a pilot. Mm-hmm. Like, it's not a woman's job.
Or you want to be a fashion designer.
Yeah, they'll be like, what do you want to do in fashion designing? Yeah. Or like now that handwork pays. Or like now that there's this, social media has made fashion design look like a very big deal. Or like when we're growing up. Now that, I think that's my fear of not being accepted for who I am. Okay, I want to be this. Oh, you can do it. Go ahead. I accept it that this is what you want to be. This is what you want to do. I think that's my own greatest fear. It's been fun having you here.
Honestly,
and I've gained a lot of insights.
It's been super fun for me. And I'm very sure that everyone who's been watching us today has had fun too. Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you very much for coming. For observations and comments, you can still join the chat on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram. I leave you with a quote from Marilyn Monroe. It says, "One of the best things that ever happened to me is that I'm a woman. That is the way all females should feel." Until next time, I am Adebowale Omoyajuwo. Enjoy.